Now we'll discuss degrees of freedom for different type of gas molecules. See, first we discuss about monoatomic gas molecule. As we already studied, the degrees of freedom are the number of ways in which a gas molecule can distribute or utilize its total energy. Say we are having a monoatomic gas molecule, it can be regarded like a spherical molecule. We know that gas molecule can move three-dimensionally in any direction. So this gas molecule will have its velocity components distributed in the three mutually perpendicular directions, which are Vx, Vy and Vz. This we already studied that the total energy of molecule can be distributed in three translational dimensions. So this monoatomic gas molecules has translational degrees of freedom. Ft can be written as 3. We talk about its rotational energy. The molecule can also rotate about x axis, y axis and z axis. Say with an angular speed omega x, omega y and omega z. So if we talk about the kinetic energy in its rotational motion, it can be taken as half I omega x square, half I omega y square and half I omega z square. But in this situation, if I is taken as moment of inertia, and if the molecule is taken to be spherical, its moment of inertia will be 2 by 5 mr square. And as in our assumption, we already considered in postulates of kinetic theory of gases that the size of gas molecule is negligible. So if this r is negligible, this will be tending to 0. So if moment of inertia is 0, even if the molecule spins or rotates, it won't contain or consume any energy in its rotational motion because the moment of inertia of this particle is negligibly small. So when we talk about rotational degrees of freedom of the gas molecule, these rotational degrees can be written as 0. So total, we take the degrees of freedom for a monoatomic gas molecule to be 3. Next is the diatomic gas molecule. We know that in a diatomic gas molecule, there are two atoms connected by a bond. And this is the structure of a diatomic gas like hydrogen, oxygen or nitrogen. And when we talk about this gas molecules, it can also move in x, y and z direction with the translational velocities Vx, Vy and Vz. So its translational degrees of freedom will always be 3, or you can write always every gas molecule has 3 translational degrees of freedom. And if we talk about its rotational motion, it can also rotate about x axis, about y axis and about z axis. Here you can see we can ignore the size of gas molecule, but we cannot ignore the bond length. So if it is rotating about x axis, we can say the particles are spinning, so its moment of inertia about x axis will be 0. So no energy will be contained due to rotation in x direction with say angular speed omega x. But you can imagine and realize the situation that if the molecule rotates about y axis with angular speed omega y, or if it will rotate about z axis with the angular speed omega z, the particles, these molecules, molecular atoms will also revolve about the axis and their moment of inertia will not be negligible. So in this situation, when we talk about rotational degrees of freedom for a diatomic gas molecule, it can be taken as 2. So in total, there are 5 degrees of freedom for diatomic gas molecule. As being a linear molecule, its rotational motion can be ignored about the axis along the bond length of the molecule. And sometimes it happens that at very high temperature, the bond becomes flexible and the atomic, this molecular atoms will start oscillating about this particular bond. And we can say at high temperature, a vibrational motion also starts. So we can state vibrational degrees of freedom will also come in picture, and this Fp can be written as 2, because for the two atoms they'll also contain or utilize the total energy in form of vibrational energy also. So we can write in the situation at high temperature, total degrees of freedom for a diatomic gas can be taken as 7. But at low temperature, we can easily ignore this vibrational degrees of freedom and we take total degrees of freedom to be only 5. Let's talk about the polyatomic gas molecule. When we talk about the polyatomic gas molecule, there are 2 types of polyatomic gas molecule. One are linear molecules, other are non-linear molecules. Linear are like carbon dioxide, where the bonds of all the atoms are in a line. Non-linear is like, if we talk about H2O, it will be like this. A water vapor molecule where the bonds are not in same line. So, it is a 3-dimensional situation. Again, as we have studied in all kind of cases, when we talk about translational degrees of freedom, each gas molecule has 3 translational degrees of freedom, whether it is linear or non-linear. But when we talk about rotational degrees of freedom, in case of a linear molecule, again, if we talk about the rotation or spinning effect of all these atoms along the line joining these bonds or the line along the bonds, the rotational motion can be ignored. So, rotational degrees of freedom can be taken as 2. But in case of non-linear molecule, as being a 2-dimensional or 3-dimensional structure, about any axis, its rotational motion can't be ignored. So, rotational degrees of freedom will be 3. So, in total, we can take number of degrees of freedom in case of a linear polyatomic gas molecule are 5, and degrees of freedom in case of a non-linear gas molecule, non-linear polyatomic gas molecule are 6. Here, I have not taken any vibrational degrees of freedom. If some vibrational degrees of freedom, say x degrees of freedom exists, then the total number of degrees of freedom including vibrational degrees of freedom will be 5 plus x in case of linear diatomic molecule, and it is 6 plus x in case of non-linear polyatomic molecule. So, be careful about the situation. Generally, vibrational degrees of freedom are not in the scope of these lectures. So, we are not going to take up any example for vibrational degrees of freedom.